Hello, fellow YouTubers. As you know, I'm telling you that I'm going to make a screencast about this animated desktop that you see here. I found out about it by visiting this page right here. It's about Dreams in Animated Desktop for Linux in Ubuntu 10.04. You have some links in the description how to get the free version of a desktop. There's also a link for a newer version, but you're gonna have to pay for it. I use the free version. And then some more links about more Dreams in videos. I'm going to put these links in my description too, but check out this video. It will give you some information, though it doesn't explain how exactly you use it. Oh, it just tells you right here, but there is no tutorial video. Okay. First thing you have to do to get this animated desktop, which I will kill right now because it takes some resources, and while recording, I prefer using a light desktop, even though I have animations enabled. It doesn't take so many resources as it does by using an animated desktop. If you have no screen recorder, you can use that desktop animation, but as I said in previous videos, the actual wallpaper, animated wallpaper, will stay on top of your Plasma desktop, at least in KDE. I don't know how it does in GNOME. I don't actually use GNOME. So yeah, for you wondering how to get this desktop wallpaper, you can type on Google "last exit," go to images, and here it is. This is a version with stars, and around here is the versions with stars. Yeah, this is it, without stars. It's a smaller image. Is the one I use right here. For some reason, if I try to use the version with stars, yeah, it doesn't even show me the preview. Anyway, the desktop will get blank, so I have to use this one. The starry version has 2.8 megabytes actually, since it has 2560 by 1600 resolution. Yeah. Back to the animated wallpaper. So you must go here, right? Open this in another tab and download it from one of those hosting services. And you'll get a tar.gz file. Okay, once you've done that, you can let's see. Yeah, you must extract the archive. I extracted already. It's right here. Open it, and you have this. Open the README. Yeah, it tells you that you have to install Zenity, mPlayer, UnRAR, and RAR. So, you go to to the terminal. Copy this, paste it right here, and it will install all those. Next thing you have to do is, yeah, it says to decompress, so you already did that. That's the reason why we can read the readme, right? Install xwinwrap. Yeah, this one is for the 32-bit version. This is for the 64-bit version. I use the 64-bit OS, so I've installed the 64-bit .deb file. Okay. Then execute the 8-disk installer. And right here you'll have actually when you first install it you'll only have this Atomic City WMV file. That will be the only animation that you'll get. As you can see I've downloaded more animations. So I can choose from a variety of animated desktop. How you can actually choose those animated desktop is going to the bin file and double click a desk n or s if you want it in Spanish. I choose n. Okay, if you press if you you can see here Atomic City is already selected. If you press OK it should open the Atomic desktop but the Atomic City, but it doesn't. This is a bug, I don't know why. Actually what you should do is select your video, press OK, and in the pop-up window you go to your video and select the one that you want. As you can see earlier I had this dripping video and it's cute, it's like an ordinary, it acts like an ordinary desktop but it doesn't support widgets, Plasma widgets on top of it. All the if you and it minimizes if you press show desktop, it minimizes itself and the widgets appear from behind it. To kill this animated desktop, you double click again the A desk N and it's automatically killed unless you open another video. Let's see another video. Color cubes, let's see what color cubes. Oh yeah, this one what it does, it changes the colors. See, as you can see it goes to yellow and it will go to the whole spectrum of colors. Yeah, it is turning red right now. Anyway, I found this fun for a while but I got bored of it. I like my widgets on top until someone comes with a free version of this application that actually supports Plasma widgets on top of it. I don't think I'm gonna use it that much. Yeah, so this is it. As you could see I had more than one animated desktop and I got them from those two links right here which have a lot of animations. Yeah, you can choose from those right here. Yeah, pages and pages of animated wallpapers. And so does the second one. So make sure to check this video right here. If you like his video, subscribe. Favorite it, I sure did because it was a good information. It was a good start. I was into that for that time being. Yeah, and actually this is all I wanted to show you. It's quite actually in the GNOME version you can have it auto start on the when the system starts, and it also have a script in the right click menu of the desktop. KDE doesn't support that, unfortunately, but it's not that much of a deal to do some clicks. Planet Earth, what's Planet Earth? Oh, it's a rotating planet Earth. Yeah, you can have a lot of fun with these. At least show off. That's a good reason to have an animated wallpaper, show off. Yeah. In the future videos, I will show you how to have comp is working in KDE, how to set it. I'll also show you how to get Pigeon do the things that Yahoo Messenger does, like I don't know, having all the smiles, even the hidden ones. Just the stuff that you can normally do in Yahoo Messenger, but you could not do in Pigeon right away. Yeah, all those effects also. Yeah, so see you later. See you. Oh, I got buzzed. So yeah, watch my future videos for more insights in Linux. Bye bye.